Hey, this is Kirk from the DynamoDB team, and today we are talking about backup and restore with DynamoDB tables.
There are two types of backups offered with DynamoDB: on-demand backups and continuous backups with point-in-time recovery. Both types of backups have three things in common: all data is encrypted at rest, the ability to restore to another AWS region, and being able to backup petabytes worth of data with no performance impacts on your base table. First up is continuous backups with point-in-time recovery. These are continuous incremental backups that allow you to restore to any 1 second in the last 35 days. There is nothing to maintain and no scheduling required. More than likely, you should have a good reason to not have continuous backups enabled on your production tables. My favorite feature of continuous backups is that beyond simple restores, is it enables exporting of your table's data to S3 and other services without affecting the performance of your base table in DynamoDB. This enables you to run services like Athena and machine learning over that same data to make the data even more useful to you. On-demand backups are used to create a full backup of your table, a snapshot, if you will. It provides long-term retention and meets regulatory compliance needs. On-demand backups can be cataloged, discoverable, and retained until explicitly deleted. You can create on-demand backups via the AWS console, API, CLI, or the AWS Backup Service. For on-demand backups of your DynamoDB table, the AWS Backup Service should be your go-to mechanism. AWS Backup Service offers end-to-end management of on-demand backups for DynamoDB. It automates scheduled backups and retention enforcement. You can copy backups between AWS regions and accounts, as well as restore backups between AWS regions. You can store backups in encrypted AWS vaults, which you can secure multiple different ways, including an encryption key that's different from the DynamoDB base table encryption key. My second favorite feature of AWS backups is being able to automatically move older backups to a cold storage tier and thus save on storage costs. And finally, your backups inherit tags from your source DynamoDB tables, allowing you to use those tags to set permissions and service control policies on your backups. All right, let's look at a demo real quick. Here we have a table called Parcel Tracker in the DynamoDB console. We're on the Backups tab, and I'm going to turn on Continuous Backups with Point-in-Time Recovery. I click Edit, I click Enable, I hit Save Changes, and I'm done. It is now backing up every single item that is written or updated in this table. Now, let's set up an On-Demand Backup. I'm going to hit Create Backup, Create On-Demand Backup. I have some options here if I want to. If I do the default, it'll use the AWS Backup Service. It'll start in the next 1 hour. It won't use cold storage, and it won't have a retention period on it. It'll just always be there until I delete it. I do this, and then I hit Create Backup, and the AWS Backup Service will go ahead and start creating the backup for me. You can see that I already have two backups that I created just a little bit ago. In summary, on-demand backups are usually for regulated industries where you have longer retention times or when you need the features of the AWS Backup Service. Remember, it's best practice to enable continuous backups with point-in-time recovery. You should have a really good reason not to have continuous backups enabled on your tables. Also, this is not an either-or scenario. You can use both backup methods to your advantage. One final thing, it's considered best practice to regularly test your backups. Make sure you can restore those tables. Make sure all the data that you think should be there is there. Just remember there's a cost component to doing restores. So make sure you check the link for the documentation in the description for this video.
Thanks, and be on the lookout for more core concept videos here and on our Twitter handle @DynamoDB.